the world thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder. Thy power throughout the universe displayed.
When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart.
Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art.
Then sings my soul, sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great
God bless you. I am Mark Anthony DiBello, and this is the first message of a preaching and teaching and just story sharing of the life that the Lord God, through His Son, Jesus Christ, and the power of the Holy Spirit, would like us to live and to lead. And I'm blessed to speak to you all, whomever may be listening. And I'm going to do this daily, prayerfully, when I first wake up. Today, actually, I mistakenly got started with my day, and this day happens to be my birthday. Although a beloved uncle of mine once said, it's not really your birthday, you're only born once, it's the anniversary of your birthday. Well, my purpose behind this message, preaching and teaching, is to just minister the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ and God, and just happenings in the world and amongst the angels and all the created beings. It's always been, I believe, my calling to preach, to teach, to try to live a life like Jesus Christ. Well, God knows I've done anything but. I've had moments and memories where I have, and I've tried to act like Christ, or I tried to speak like Christ. I even had a moment where I said I want to just think Jesus. So, in this mass media age and the way technology has advanced amazingly. You know, when Jesus preached, he over 2,000 years ago, by the date today, December 18th, 2014, 2014 years ago, when he began his life and began his teaching and preaching ministry, just a handful of years or a couple of years before his death at the age of 33, I think. I'm sorry, it's 33 or 34. You know, God forgive me for not knowing that, but I promise you in the days and weeks to come I'll know that exactly. It's been a while, you know, I've been away from God. And the point again behind this preaching and speaking and teaching is to just minister. I'm going to, you know, even if it's not going throughout the world. And my point with Jesus was he just spoke to the people of the day. They didn't even write the gospel stories of him until 30 years or more after his death. And in that age, you know, people, that's how they recorded. You know, they wrote, excuse me for my ailing voice. But, you know, we're all blessed. I'm blessed, every one of us, to have life and ears to listen and eyes to see this day, a mind to think and a heart to feel. And I just want to begin my day, and this the first day of the rest of my life, as many people have said, but mostly fulfill, I hope, with that which is a calling, and, you know, live every day as if it were our last. I'm certainly going to put that on the top of my thought processes and my mindset, and, you know, call it a resolution list even before New Year's gets here. I'm not the type to celebrate the mass holidays the way most people do. I'd rather be alone with the Lord God. You know, Jesus spent most of his time alone. That's why so much of his life wasn't recorded. He'd wake up early in the morning and go alone and in the darkness or in the early of the morn and be alone with his Father, the Father. So I'm going to try to do that every morning and then just share my thoughts to whomever might be listening. I'm going to keep this message to anywhere between 30 or 40 minutes. I'll probably, and this will be the pattern, and hopefully do it for 1 year, just play some music to begin or, and, you know, to end the message. Just edit it briefly a little bit. Maybe put some pictures up or a single picture or a montage of some sort. But I'll probably start it with some Elvis singing How Great Thou Art, at least this first message. And then end maybe with the same song. I'll put a title to the message and list the title. Hopefully, the song, and the song especially, it's not restricted for its use. And then I'll just speak for about 30 minutes, and again, whatever the Lord wants me to share with the world, because, you know, I have it posted on a video, and this is what I love about the technology of today, whether it's video or audio or the written word, internet, television, radio, film. And there's so many ways to make ourselves, in a way, eternal, the eternal recorded image. What a great human invention and creation. And prayerfully and hopefully and God-inspired, something that's used for good. And, you know, the gospel means the good news. So life in itself, being able to speak and teach and being alive, is good news enough most days, right? Every day for people, myself especially. It's been on the brink and near death for many, many years, and certainly this one of the toughest years of my life. But what better way to start all of our days, right? You know, we open with a prayer, speak to the Lord, and then meditate after we speak and listen. I mean, that's what prayer is. It's speaking and listening to God. It's not just talking to Him, and it's certainly not just asking things. But I'll get into a message on prayer at some point, as I could talk about God every day if I possibly could, for as many hours as He gives me the breath to speak and to the life to live and the air to breathe. So again, what I'll do is try to do 6 days a week, half an hour. Just maybe I'll take some notes myself. I can certainly encourage you to perhaps write some things down, you who are listening. And we'll take this spiritual journey together. I don't know how this recording or program will turn out to be, but it only starts with one listener. You know, every long journey starts with one step. Nobody walks 1,000 miles until they walk 1 foot. And Jesus and His ministry 2,014 years later or so was, it's time probably, well, let's say He lived to be 33, so 2000, or let's see, He was born in what we dated the year zero, lived to be 33, so 2014 minus 33 is 1981 years. 1981 years. And look how far the gospel has spread to at least a documented or census recorded or whomever does the statistics, perhaps 2 billion or 3 billion of the 8 or 9 billion people on the planet as I speak confess or profess to be Christians. So God works in miraculous and amazing ways and in His time. It's my time to at least start speaking about Him more than I've tried, and hopefully to a level much more than I have, because I feel so much like I failed Him. I mean, I'm sure you feel perhaps the same way, you who are listening, and I don't want you to think this message or these messages or this internet ministry, if you will, is really about me. It's not going to be. It's really about sharing the gospel and the good news and things that, you know, you might not have heard before, or ways of looking at the scripture and the Bible and, you know, the God of the Bible and Jesus, His Son, and the Holy Spirit, and thinking and believing and feeling things that you didn't quite either understand or discern, or just maybe the knowledge wasn't made clear to you. Because I know the gifts that the Lord has given me, and probably the most blessed thing that I can do in the way of ministry for people is to share the knowledge that God has given me. I call that Gnosticism, or being a Gnostic. He's really blessed me with incredible, I believe, intellect and knowledge, and knowledge of Him, you know, and the way He creates and the way He exists and the way He lives, and His Son Jesus' teachings and preachings and speaking, and, you know, the old saying, no time like the present. So if this is a way to start the day, in a good way, I mean, for a few reasons. One, it just brings us into fellowship with the Lord God, and that's the way every day should begin. You know, I used to live by an alarm clock, as I'm sure a lot of people do in this world system of 9 to 5. But I try to personally, positively, I don't really always like to use the word pride, but I just try to dedicate myself to waking up naturally. I feel it's the Lord who's waking me up then, and He'll have me up in His time, in the right time, and He'll do it for all of us, any of us, if you believe that and live that, and you'll come to be, you know, taught that yourself through your own self way of, you know, watching as how your day progresses, and it's productivity, and it's peace and all the good things that God provides and all His blessings. So begin the day naturally and with the Lord waking us up, and whether He spoke to us in a dream that night or again as we wake up and pray or meditate. So it's just the perfect and only way really to start any and every day. You know, it's Jesus who gives us that day. You know, the Bible says, "This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." Because, as I noted, one day it will end. And the Bible says, like a thief in the night, you'll be on your roof mending and going about your day and working, and then the thief will come who steals life, and it'll be gone that day, that moment, that blink of an eye. So we must live our lives that fully. It's such a spiritually liberating experience to really take that into your heart and your mindset and your words. You know, the Lord created the universe, all of creation, with just His spoken word. That's how valuable our words are. That's how powerful and meaningful they are. How life-giving they are. One word will always, to every human being, one day be our last. So it's that important to open our day in speech or in thought or in mindset, even with one another. You know, the Lord God said that we're to love God with all our heart and our soul and our being, and to love one another or our neighbor or mankind as we love ourselves. So if you really want to love the Lord God, you really want to love one another, and you really, really want to love yourself. A lot of people forget that part of that biblical text. It's to also love yourself. And the best thing anyone can do to love themselves is to wake up and fellowship with their Savior, the Lord God, Jesus Christ, and prayerfully in the power of the Holy Spirit. And if we're blessed to be able to speak and to teach, to record and to preach, then we should do it with one another. I mean, that's something that, you know, I just feel I'm blessed to be able to give and to do, and He's given me a great voice, I believe. Not necessarily my tone or my dialect or my accent, but a great voice in that it's a calling, a life's passion, a dream. Lord knows, and no pun intended, but I would speak to the highest, from the highest mountaintop if I could. And I'm doing that, trying to do that actively in all ways of media, just spread His word and who He is and the way He is. But another way, another blessed, and I'll speak more again about so many topics, and I just pray that you're blessed and enlightened and helped and healed by them, because one of the other things that opening your day with preaching or even going to church or listening to a gospel message or creating a work of art for the Lord or doing any of the things that the Lord God Jesus Christ would do in His day when He was alive is, and especially for me this year of all years where I'm such at a loss sometimes for even just wanting to exist and live and breathe, and whether it's, you know, depression or suicidal thoughts or temptations or sins or just the daily course of life where Satan is out there like a roaring lion looking to destroy us and to attack us and to kill us, is it's a great way to ward him off to begin the day, because every day is a gift. It's a blessed gift. That's what life is. You know, people often ask, what's the meaning of life? Well, the meaning of life is two or threefold. Number one, it's a gift from God. That's really all it is. It's just a gift. It's just something because He loves us. He wanted to do. He wanted to create man in His own image. Man and womankind, even the animals, are very godly beings. I mean, the Bible, you read the Bible, the first words in the Bible are, "In the beginning God created." So who is God? He's time. He's Father Time. In the beginning He created all. I mean, it's unfathomable to try to think, to even imagine the breadth and the depth of the mind of God and what He's thinking and feeling and the love that He has for us. So He created time in the beginning. And what is He? He's a creator, the creator of everything and anything that exists in this earth. Yes, he creates, but there are things that have been not even created by man, but man has used God. You know, man has taken on the mind and the creativity of God to make so many good things in this world, so many godly things that Jesus would make. You know, he was a carpenter. He used his hands. He made things. He thought. He had so many amazing gifts and talents to create. Now, there are things that the devil, he'll pervert, Satan, he'll take something, and man will use his evil-minded, sinful human nature and take something and build it from scratch or pervert it or just make it look so good that it's almost like God, but it's not. I mean, that's how the devil works and operates. He seems so godlike. He's the God of this earth and this age, but he's not the God, the ultimate God of eternity and the earth eternal and heaven above, heaven in eternity. But again, to create and to live and to breathe in this time that we are living in this media, you know, I can only pray that what I say and what the Lord reveals to me and some things I've written and a lot I'm going to keep mysterious and not unveil or reveal, some things I've tried to do on mainstream television or in film or even in these recordings on the internet, whatever the case may be, music, people create so much music for the Lord. I mean, that's why I love Elvis the King. He sang so many beautiful gospel songs, but that's the value of the recorded image and the gift that God has given us with it and the way we've used his mind and our minds, one with him, to create and to work it and to have it be that way. Because to me, and I tell people this, you know, I kind of say it in a work sense, but I just want to really tell you the goal of my calling in my life, and I can only pray that you follow me. And I'm not saying I'm Jesus, Lord knows, God, no, again, no literal pun intended, but he knows I'm not him. None of us are, but we aspire to be him, man or woman. You know, we should act like Jesus, think Jesus. I loved when they had those What Would Jesus Do bracelets. I mean, that was a great mindset to just help us to live the life of Christ, filled with the Holy Spirit, to be one with our Father, our Creator, and home in heaven with him in eternity. But my goal as a preacher, because I, again, just a blessed, his putting his hand, I think, on my life, just as he's put his hand on your life in many ways, I'm sure, you who are listening. We want to do what the Father says, create, be who he created us to be. The closer we are to him, the more one we are with him, the more godlike, the more holy, the more perfect, the more like his Son Jesus, the more empowered with the Holy Spirit within us, is the only way to have an eternity and to live. So again, for me, in the way of preaching, it's my goal, and I have expressed this, to preach to as many people as humanly possible. And the best ways that I can do that are, as far as I believe, if there's 8 billion people on the planet, to 4 billion, I can only get to half, only because if I even get there at my age now, and again, this is my birthday, my celebration thereof of my birth, is to get to as many as I can through whatever way I can. And that happens to this day in a way, be media and technology. And if I can preach to half, because life is good and bad, positive and negative, and I'll give a message on that, I promise you. But I've wasted or lost, or Satan has stolen half my life, and I believe the other half probably split right down the middle, 20. Well, there's my age. I'm 54 today. So 27 years good, 27 years evil or bad. Prayerfully, I can hopefully make the next, if God should be so willing to give me 27 minutes or 27 days or prayerfully 27 years, make them the most godly I can and preach and teach and reach the most people possible, as we should all do. But I can only ask that if you're not a preacher or teacher, just as Jesus did, just follow me. follow me. He didn't ask. He didn't beg. I mean, he asked, but he didn't beg. He didn't force. He just said, follow me. So my goals would be for us, as he once called his followers followers, and then he called them friends, for people who all say are friends, is to, again, reach as many people as possible with the good news of the Lord God Jesus Christ. And one way I believe to do that is on television, both ways actually, through my first purpose and goal, I believe, is the writing of my story of my experience with angels and Jesus, personal, one-on-one, personal relationship, you know. Unless we have a personal relationship with Christ or are not born again, we'll not see the kingdom of heaven. But my personal relationship with him and ability to write and all that he's told me about angels, and who are another godly creation. And if my film can be produced and made, it's already been written, and it's blessed enough to win an Academy Award, then I'll get the blessed opportunity to speak to 2 billion people and tell them about Jesus. You know, a preacher I listened to said, what's the best thing we can do? And you've heard this, you know, actions speak louder than words, but sometimes the best thing we can do is just tell people how Jesus saved our life. You know, your life and my life. It's not enough to be born again. I mean, it's really the first thing, and I'll get into a message on that later, but, you know, he can save our life. He saves it for eternity, but he can resurrect our life. I mean, I can't tell you how many near-death experiences I've had this year, how many, whether self-induced or just violated or victimized by Satan, just his murderous, destructive, killing spirit to just try to take my life. But Jesus healed me. He saved me. He can resurrect us as he did Lazarus. So the healing and resurrection power of Jesus and his life-saving and life-giving power of the life that he created for us is his blessing us for being born again. You know, he's given me the ability to write this story about his son, or Jesus himself, I'm sorry, God the Father and the Holy Spirit and the angels. So if I can ever, with everybody's help, I need the world's help. If people don't see it, when it prayerfully, if it ever gets made, you know, it's the old tree in the forest, does it make a noise type of thing. But anyways, the purpose is to stand before 2 billion people with an Academy Award winning film and tell them about the Lord Jesus Christ. The other purpose would be to take the blessed ability he's given me to play in the game of football. I was blessed at birth to have played, and now I've used my mind and I use the expression preach football. You know, sports is they're glorious games. They're ways, you know, play that we learn to survive and fend for ourselves in this life. You know, all the little animals do it. You know, the parent animals teach their kids, and, you know, even from birth into babies, how to exist and to survive and in their way serve God. Yes, in their way. So with my blessed mind and preaching ability for football, I'm trying to help a team, any team, or at least appear during the Super Bowl broadcast. The Super Bowl, the one big game play event for humankind in the world. In the U.S. alone, millions and millions of viewers, and I believe also worldwide, 2 billion viewers. 2 billion. That's as many Christians, basically, as Jesus has, for lack of a better word, created in almost 2,000 years, the Lord God. I mean, surely Jesus was the beginning and the end, and he said the beginning, I am. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. So he's been around much longer than that, but my point is, that's 4 billion people, 2 billion on the Academy Awards and 2 billion on the Super Bowl broadcast, and then I have a calling and a goal after that. I don't want to talk about it now. It's been written. I've planned it out for many, many years, but it's sort of I wouldn't say the second half, but the rest of my life, and how I'm, again, with friends and followers and helpers and just Christians in common, how we can do this. You know, when Jesus spoke, and I'll end every message with a God bless you or peace, just as I opened it with God bless you and introduced myself to you, and we all have a name. Jesus said there's great value in everybody's name, and you're named and you're called. So I mentioned my name because God gave me that name. Surely he used my blessed, I believe, blessed. We all have, you know, love for our parents, but my father first taught me about God, and even my mother before she passed, and more so even after she passed. I've learned more about God than I could ever have learned while she was alive. That's been saved many, many times, and her, in that way, you know, a Christ-like death is, you know, not that she was Christ, but her death is, I learned so much about life in Jesus, having to just come to know him better, and just the way he died on the cross to save us from our sins. And prayerfully, I've learned that life isn't perfect. No, there's sin and there's heartache and there's hatred and there's loss, there's death, and there's an end. So as I come to the end of this message, again, I'll edit in a song. I want to thank you all, whether it's 1 or 100 or 1 million, or prayerfully one day 1 or 2 billion. Thank you for spending your time and your life with me today and allowing me to speak to you and prayerfully introduce myself to you, but more so, the Lord God, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, and the Father. I love you, and God bless you.
When I think of how he came so far from glory, came to dwell among the lowly such as I, to suffer shame and such disgrace, on Mount Calvary take my place. Then I ask myself this question, who am I? Who am I that a king would bleed and die for? Who am I that he would pray, not my will, thine, Lord? The answer I may never know, why he ever loved me so, that to an old rugged cross he'd go, for who am I? When I'm reminded of his words, I'll leave you never. If you'll be true, I'll give to you life forever. Oh, I wonder what I could have done to deserve God's only Son, to fight my battles until they're won. For who am I? Thank you. pray, not my will, thine, Lord. The answer I may never know, why he ever loved me so, that to an old rugged cross he'd go, for who am I? That to an old rugged cross he'd go, for who am I?